plays almost half the game for his team, trying to snap the 1-1 series wishbone Pittsburgh's way.
It is remarkable when you think about it that Sidney Crosby has never scored an overtime game-winning goal in the playoffs.
The Penguins exploded out of the gate in Game 2. Save made by Vasilevsky! What a break in the first 10 seconds! And continued to attack Tampa's 21-year-old netminder. Bolstered by the return of a veteran presence and the continued emergence of a talented youngster.
Shot! Score!
A 2-2 tie remained that way through regulation, with the Lightning goalie responding to the pressure.
What a save by Vasilevsky!
And when 60 minutes weren't enough, it was overtime magic, finally for Pittsburgh's captain. Ross Delays to Crosby, score!
He's got an overtime game-winning goal now.
For the first time in his decorated playoff career, sudden death became sudden Sidney's moment to shine. And now a series tied at one shifts to the Sunshine State. It's Game 3, Eastern Conference Final, next. Downtown Tampa, Florida, it's the Stanley Cup Playoffs presented by GEICO. Game 3, best of 7, Eastern Conference Final. A win apiece for the Pittsburgh Penguins and the Tampa Bay Lightning. And good evening, everyone, with Eddie Olczyk, Pierre McGuire coming up shortly. I'm Mike Emmerich. Even before game number 2, you were suggesting the Pittsburgh Penguins should put together Sidney Crosby and Evgeny Malkin. They did. Your thoughts?
Well, I think they needed to ignite the big guys, that being Crosby and Malkin, and then Mike Sullivan doesn't want to take credit, Doc, but I think it ignited the big guys and it ignited his team to a win in Game 2 back in Pittsburgh. If you think about the first shift of the game that he played Malkin and Crosby together, I mean, look at his magic. Letang to Malkin, Crosby on the back end, and not for an incredible save by Andrei Vasilevsky. They would have scored a goal on that first shift, but I think it brought energy. And then in the third period, what did he do? Mike Sullivan, that is. He only played 11 forwards. Connor Sheary never hit the ice. And they got energy, they dictated the terms, and they were able to eventually win the game in overtime. So I think the slight adjustment by head coach Mike Sullivan got the Penguins a win in overtime off the goal from Sidney Crosby. And you know, anytime a coach changes the lines, it gets the attention of all the guys, especially the big guys.
Well, the Tampa Bay Lightning, from the start of the second period on, were outshot 27-13, outchanced 13-8. What do they need to do for a spark here?
Well, they need to skate, and they need their top two scorers in the playoffs to get on the score sheet, because they have not done that in the first two games of the Eastern Conference Final, and that's Tyler Johnson and Nikita Kucherov. These are two players that are dynamic, and Kucherov had some chances. Now, Tyler Johnson hasn't been the same since he got hit in Game 1, Doc. Remember when Chris Kunitz took him out, he missed a period of time. But these are two players that are so important to John Cooper, the terrific head coach of the Tampa Bay Lightning. They got to play more inside the dots. They need more support in the offensive zone. But all in all, they got to skate, because when they are skating, they are a dangerous dynamic duo. Kucherov and Johnson need to get on the score sheet, and the way they're going to do that is playing inside the dots and creating offensive opportunities.
Here in Tampa, the Lightning have won 5 out of 6 home games. As with any venue change, especially after an overtime loss, repairs are made. We'll get the opinion on this of Pierre McGuire inside the glass in just a moment. It is time now for the Honda starting goaltenders. Beginning with Matt Murray. Doesn't start of the playoffs. A rookie, brilliant all spring, has stopped 36 of 41 in the series. Only 21. He is terrific. Andrei Vasilevsky, brilliant in relief in Game 1, brilliant in defeat in Game 2, has stopped 63 of 67 shots. He's only 21, and he's terrific. Sidney Crosby with a storybook finish for Penguins fans again, said yesterday, whether you win in overtime or 5-1, it's still only one victory. Going after number 2 here. Nikita Kucherov needs what Crosby needed last game, a goal in this series. He leads the Eastern Conference in playoff goals with 9, but no points in the 2 games of this series so far. six defensemen for John Cooper's Lightning tonight. Often he has played seven, goes with six, and so a full raft of forwards. And the ones he starts with are very defensively oriented. Brian Boyle, Cedric Paquette, and Ryan Callahan back from the flu. Going against Crosby and Kunitz and Hornquist for the Penguins, Trevor Daly, Ben Lovejoy on defense, Anton Stralman and Victor Hedman, the aces of the defense for the Lightning, and they are the first to play this. And icing 6 seconds in.
Well, we talked about the line adjustments by Mike Sullivan back in Pittsburgh for game two. And he starts the game with the line that he ended. To Kunitz, Hornquist, and Crosby trio, and 6 seconds in, Mike Sullivan makes a quick change and face off to the left of Vasilevskiy.
He wants to keep Crosby away from Boyle. The size of his mask more than anything else.
This one came back on to Stralman from the faceoff win by Boyle. Two for two for him. Flexed along by Callahan and back in, and it's patted away by Murray. Taken along by Daly, and the first fire wagon change for John Cooper. And the Lightning. Ahead comes Malkin with this, able to escape back in, but then it's tapped away and can be rushed right back up by Drouin. Drouin holds and wanted to pull the trigger on a shot, but could not. Rust was there. Played on back for Schuster to lead back over to Hedman. His shot was well wide. So wide, it might have been a shot pass. Around this goes near Palat. Keep to the live, the leading hitter in this series for them. A shot by Schuster is saved, and right back out off of Murray. Played back out again by Connor Sheary, and around to get it is Schuster.
Schuster with a good chance there. I think he was hoping for one of his forwards to be around Matt Murray. Murray able to see that. Big rebound given up. Good opportunity there for the Lightning using their defenseman in the offensive zone.
Sullivan tried to change on the fly to keep Crosby away. Right away, Cooper comes with Boyle, Callahan, and Paquette.
Rushed along, and it's Paquette turning it on back, and it's gathered in by Letang. Chris Letang played one dangerously near the Lightning, and it came along for Paquette, who turns, hands it on to the back. Garrison a shot off the boards, then blocked away by the shaft of the stick of Murray. Along to take it again, Johnson twisted one that was just away from Paquette, chased down by Kunitz, and slugged geometrically back in near Crosby, but he couldn't take. So he battles and is able to come up with it and got some help. It's Hagelin with a shot that's turned aside by Vasilevskiy. Jammed out there, it popped along to Kucherov and pinching along with Lovejoy. Puck came on back now and it's Daly with it. A wrister and that one blocked to the corner and done well there by Garrison. Twisted along by Schuster, Paquette is rammed by Lovejoy after he'd released that one. Phil Kessel glides on back with it, banged it back off the boards, and all the way up it comes for Bonino to give across to Hagelin with speed moving in. Pulled the trigger on a shot, too many Lightning there, and then Vasilevskiy made the block, and it started right back ahead by Kalorn. Starting to go end-to-end here, aren't they? Across for a shot that is just geared right back out again. High off the body of Matt Murray.
Well, Matt Carl had Nikita Kucherov wide open. Great entry by the Tampa Bay Lightning on that 3-on-2.
Yes, he did, Eddie.
Well, a quick developing play. The Penguins have talked a lot about the transition of the Tampa Bay Lightning. Kalorn, Carl, and there you see Kucherov opening up, hoping for a pass to the left of Matt Murray. Never bad play to get the puck to the net, but look how wide open Kucherov is there. There was the passing lane as Justin Schultz came over to try to take away that shot. I think with the Tampa Bay Lightning are very effective, and I think the Penguins as well, is when they have defensemen jumping into the play, turning two-on-twos into three-on-twos.
It appeared Murray wanted that with the glove, but got it with the helmet mask nonetheless. This one is rolled right back in. After it is Dumoulin. Then around behind, sandwiched to Stralman to the boards by Matt Cullen's checking. Squirts on free and is played back along by Nemesnikov. Right in on goal and a save. Rebound and another save is made by Murray. Scramble there and it's around behind, battled for. Cannot be centered though by Marchessault, and it bounces on to be played back in by Tom Kunackel.
Another defenseman involved on that play. That's Anton Stralman with that quality chance.
Hedman had it knocked away. Everyone looking for it, and it's magically right to him. Right back up the wing it comes. Drouin drops it off. Nemestnikov turning with it there. Rattled it around for Drouin, trying to turn away from Lovejoy. Lovejoy prevailed and popped it by him, and there's help. To the back it comes now to Schuster. Rolled it back around again. Daly slowed it down and then went right after it. Jammed it, but into some traffic. Daly tries it behind, hoping Lovejoy can play it. Back up the boards he tried. Fildered on along and eventually out to center ice by Hagelin. Sent on ahead now to Malkin, and his shot is snapped and held by Vasilevskiy.
He was just talking about Anton Stralman, who scored a goal in game number two. You're going to see him sneak in. Marchessault tries to chip that, and eventually the puck finds its way to Anton Stralman, wide open. You see him take a hit to make a play down low for Matt Cullen. Marchessault with really good support, keep the play alive, get to the front of the net, no coverage at all. Zero resistance against six and blue. And he just can't find a way to fool Matt Bird.
And a good job there by JT Brown to recognize that Anton Stralman, a defenseman, was involved in the offense. So what does he do? He pulls back out and makes sure that he's filling in for his teammate.
Two scoring chances in the game, both by Lightning defensemen. You mentioned Stralman, also Carl. Play continues. Rattled on around by Schultz, tipped on across by Kunitz. Overskated by Crosby and brought back in on an offside.
Tampa with a huge edge in faceoffs. They've won all four faceoffs so far in this game, and both teams want to dictate the terms puck management. Here Ian Cole impedes the progress of Cedric Paquette. And 19,000 linesmen, Doc, right, that put their arms up. The referee said play on, but faceoff, such an important part for both of these teams.
And John Cooper's having his way. Last change on home ice. Anytime Crosby's out there, Boyle, Paquette, Callahan, every single pass.
So if you're Mike Sullivan, you play the game, do you hold him back? Do you try to double shift him? Those are the cat and mouse games, because you know all it takes is one time to get Crosby or one of your other skilled players on the ice when it's not advantageous for the other side and the puck ends up in the back of the net.
Johnson, a shot that got the glass, bounced free. Johnson tried to play it, took a fortunate bounce for the Lightning, but he couldn't make the play in front. Lifted back in by Stralman and grabbed carefully by Matt Murray.
Eddie, one of the things I do is I put Malkin with Crosby, double them up, see if they can handle double shifts. I try to foul up the Tampa matchups, put Crosby and Malkin together like you had suggested before game two, and see what Cooper does. That's what I do if I were the Penguins.
Kessel drops, Malkin takes. Kessel there, it's sent back onto Malkin, shouldered off by Palat. And Palat can turn back to the offensive, triple it on through, and it's brought back up now. Putting on the brakes is Drouin. Drouin chased off, though, by Lovejoy. Back out away from him, but clearly out of the way from Hornquist.
Second time now in this game, Drouin has come down those left wing boards, and he's had a chance to just get the puck to the net, and he's pulled up both times. Remember, a bad play to get that puck to the net might open up a second chance opportunity. He has such great offensive instincts with the passing part of it. Sometimes you got to take advantage when the shot is there to let it go.
He's got it again. A goal in each of the two games of this series so far for Drouin.
And you got the hot stick, so anytime you get a chance, go ahead and fire it at the net.
This is settled down now by Cullen. He picks up a man on the wing. It's Cullen bringing it on in. Crosses backhander, and that went wide. The guy up the wing was Ian Cole, a defenseman. This was jammed around by Schuster. Bounced onto Cullen, rammed there by Boyle. Delayed and played around behind through Schuster. Up for grabs, and so stepping to it is Letang. Backhanded it in. It is Kunockel behind. Fed one on out. It came to the back, and a shot by Dumoulin missed the net. So the Lightning guilty of some trouble in their own end. Sent around now, Dumoulin there. Checked off by JT Brown. And it just lobbed back out to safety. And coming to the bench for a change is Val Filppula. Nearly 6.5 played first period. The shots are 5-2 Lightning. And icing is called. Don't miss a moment of the Stanley Cup playoffs with NBC Sports Live Extra, streaming every game free with your TV subscription that includes NBCSN. Available online, on the go, and on connected TVs. For details, visit nbcsports.com/liveextra. Won by Johnson, taken by Coburn, handed over to Kucherov. Oh, and a connection to the front failed on Carl. Another shot is turned aside by Murray on the try by Coburn, who flexes it ahead. Played back through, though, by Killorn and rescued by the Penguins and poked along by Haglund. It's fed right back for Johnson and another save. Rebounds being left by Murray, but he's stopping the puck on the initial. This is picked up by Coburn, dropped back into the glove of Johnson.
Boy, that last opportunity for the Tampa Bay Lightning off a faceoff. Matt Carl, same exact play that the Lightning ran late in the third period with Anton Strahlman and just missed. This one the same thing, but just the other side.
Ben Lovejoy with this, bashes one back in that was wide and cracked off the board. Jammed behind by Hedman. Played back along further by Strahlman. Lost, though, by Kucherov. Strahlman there has it taken away by Rust. Ryan Rust around behind. Trickled one along that is read by Palat. He's able to step ahead. Rust harassing him as it stashed up the wing and becomes an offside. 12:28 to go, first period. Action in this one early. 7-2 Lightning. Nothing. Both teams have a victory in Pittsburgh. John Cooper said, we are 9-3 in the playoffs. It's tough to be hard on my team, yet we still have to have a better response. Do you think they've had one so far?
It's been a good start. I think he's got to be awfully pleased with the way that they've skated and gotten a puck in deep. And their forecheck is much more noticeable here than it was back in Pittsburgh. And look, sometimes you got to tip your hockey helmet to the other side. Penguins just did not allow them to skate. They were the quicker team for the majority of game two.
J.T. Brown played it in. Brian Dumoulin reversed it, but right into the path of Nemesnikov, then along to Carl. Forced it back off of Cullen's stick, Nemesnikov, and then Marchessault. But then the Penguins, and it's knocked away from Cullen. Careens on up to Fair, but then it is turned back over to the Lightning, and Marchessault once again. Rolled it back in, hoping for J.T. Brown. He goes rocking in, and as does Marchessault. Meanwhile, this is played back out again by Kunackel. Protected by Hedman, turned just away from Crosby, and settled down by Coburn. That click back out, and it is Kunitz with a second try, and this time he makes the safer play back for Letang to direct this one back in. Forced right along again by Vasilevsky, and then it's popped back to the corner. Turned over again by the Lightning defenders. This one comes on along for Schultz. His shot came right to the front of the net and had to be paddled away by Vasilevsky. Along it comes to Crosby, away from him, hustling to keep his Ian Cole, and he kept play alive, and then it's Schultz with it. Rammed it right back in again. It went through Crosby. Cole pinches, and along the attempt by Callahan went into him. Fed right out in front, all by Crosby to Hornquist, and Hornquist shot down by Vasilevsky. What a slick pass from the Penguins captain.
Well, this all started because of the aggressive D play by Justin Schultz and Ian Cole, keeping the pucks along the boards alive. And then there you see the skill level of Sidney Crosby. Beautiful backhand pass there to Hornquist.
And there's that pinch that Eddie was talking about by Ian Cole, the aggressive play, sealing on the boards and the chances for Hornquist off the Ian Cole pinch.
And when you are pinching in, you're being that aggressive, you better have support. Especially when you're pinching on the strong side, the side that is that the puck is on, because if you get beat, you're gonna give up an odd man situation.
Kessel's try, ricocheted across, dumped along near Haglund, and Haglund has it. Michigan product gave it to the back. Daly drubbed it across. Held there by Lovejoy, and the shot was wide. Bounced on to Haglund, pushed it off the plain goal stick of the netminder Vasilevsky. Now Lovejoy a shot, and that one pinballed wide and is kept alive neatly by Daly. More pressure here. Bonino turns, hands it on over to Kessel. Bill Kessel delays, fed one around in front, deflected right near the goal by Haglund. Haglund again comes out in front, fed one over to Kessel, oh, that didn't go through. Kessel again tried to play and could not come up with it, and Skyhook back out. Some terrific pressure from the Penguins there. Rush back in now by Johnson, and his shot is held by Murray, and play is stopped.
Now chances galore for the Pittsburgh Penguins, settling the puck down, going to work, cycle chances off the boards, winning races. Haglund, quick as a cat, working on Jason Garrison. Look at that response by Vasilevsky, just quick as a cat, as quick as Haglund was. Vasilevsky was equally quick in goal.
Well, you see where those plays are coming from. The Penguins are getting inside the dots, and here's that opportunity. Haglund to Kessel, and what a stop with the right pad and the reaction from Phil Kessel. Looking up on the Jumbotron here Can't believe that that puck did not end up in the back of the net. But again, playing inside the dots, going to the high traffic areas. Vasilevskiy with two great saves. The first one on Hagelin off the redirect, and then the Kessel one.
Edmund gave it across. This is Drouin. Threw one, and it went through the blue paint and wide. Brought back up again by Rust. Rust hunted down by Palat. Played it back in deep. Edmund to get it there. Edmund, the guy who plays more than anyone. Looks like he might want to go coast to coast, but that one interrupted by Dumoulin, who fell, and then Rust, who played it on back.
They had a little help there. Doc Edmund pulled the skates out from under him right in front of the Penguin bench.
Pope dragged back along now and taken by Malkin, gets by one, and then is shoved down by Hedman, driving to the net. Kunitz taking the puck and holding Vasilevskiy. Not bad, is it? 9:36 to go, first period, no score in this game.
What are they doing to create their chances?
Well, they really just had that one chance, and we got caught running around a little bit. And let's be honest, they're a good team, and so, you know, I'll trade what we've done in this first 8-10 minutes here over what they've done. We're being a little bit more aggressive, commanding the puck, we're taking shots. You know, you're not going to keep them out of their zone forever, and so it's really like, it's been a good start for us.
How important is a matchup here with last change?
Well, it's only good when it works, but right now we're happy with what we're doing. You know, you get to dictate who's going out against too. At least you've got the decision to make when you're on the road. You don't have that so much.
Thanks a lot, John.
All right,
Don Cooper, the man who has coached a lot of places and won in all of them and got to the Stanley Cup final last year. Here's Letang. Ricocheted off of Hornquist, taken though by Crosby. Crosby crisply across. Dumoulin had trouble, recoiled, and fed it back in. Taken there by Vasilevskiy. Reverse, but into traffic. Coburn had to hurry. Got it past Dumoulin, and so out of harm's way. Back to take it is Letang. Knife gone back away from Kessel. More changes in line. The Penguins were without a scoring chance in the first 9 minutes, and then in the next minute came up with three. This one is doubled down then and eventually played by Hagelin, but held off enough was Bonino, so it could be played by Kucherov across, and Johnson speeds back out. Plays it in and hopes to take his own pass. Lovejoy in, and the two of them cancel. Kucherov got there and centered, but right there was Kessel. Defensively responsible on that play as this is sent back down and short of icing.
Good play by Lovejoy one-on-one with Tyler Johnson, and you like Johnson's thought process there of not trying to beat him, just chip it in and force the defenseman to turn and go back and get it.
Eddie, I don't know if Tyler Johnson's as quick as we used to see him because of that hit from Kunitz.
Here is Cullen, had his shot stymied by Killorn. Around this comes to Kunockle to the back, Letang right back on to Kunockle again. Speeds it around the board. Cullen able to take it there. Cullen fed one in front. Checked off was Kunockle, but he recovers. To the back now it's Dumoulin. A shot is directed wide as getting a stick on it was fair. Meanwhile, this is outletted ahead. And pivoting and laying it on back in is Kucherov. 7:3 to go, first period. The shots are 8 for the Lightning, 7 for the Penguins. Malkin and Sherry are a part of the forecheck. The other forward for the Penguins is Rust. That one knocked away from Namestnikov, then bunted back along by Schultz, and then stashed back out as far as Schuster. Played one along that is flexed back over near Rust. Screened off his man so there could not be an attack generated by the Lightning the other way. Until now. Marching ahead is Garrison, and that one is carefully blocked to the corner, and then another one thrown off the pad of Matt Murray. Forced onto the back again. Drouin played one along. Schuster able to get there, but then it pinballed off one Penguin to another. And a reach and a brush back out to center ice where Sherry tries to play, but it's taken back on by Drouin. Drouin hands it back over. A shot is grabbed and held by Matt Murray on the try that came from the deep slot area, and that from Filppula.
Well, what an opportunity here for the Pittsburgh Penguins as Alex Killorn gets on his horse and lifts up the stick of Matt Cullen, who's going to have an A-plus chance about 15 feet out in front of Andre Vasilevskiy, but coaches will tell you it's never too late to come back, and that man right there to Pierre's right, our camera left, I think was taking a quick little look, Pierre, at your monitor there, seeing that back check. Well done by Killorn on the back check with
he's
Matt Cullen.
That Harvard guy, he's always trying to learn something new. Absolutely.
Well, I'm going to say is it's the closest I'll ever be to Harvard.
I don't know. Your brother wants to.
Well, yeah. He is the smartest one in the family, no question.
Played along further, and it's turned back over to Kunitz. Kunitz trying to shake. Bree cannot. Might be a chance here as they roll to Callahan. Callahan a shot. A half-speeder is blocked off there by Murray, and then threaded along by Kunitz. Back up to Hornquist, trying to shunt it ahead to Crosby. No luck. In the way was Hedman. He tries again. Crosby has come to the bench. So back this goes now. No icing on the play. 6 minutes and 15 seconds as of right now to go in the first period of a scoreless game. More trouble, played by a high stick, and then turned back along and gotten by Haglund. Then across to Bonino, but in the way of that haphazard sort of play was Coburn. Kucherov led it across, and here comes Johnson. Drifts to the outside and holds. Johnson delays and spun one that is worked there by Haglund, and then he's run into by Kalorn. Seems to be okay as this play starts on back. Bonino across for Haglund. Knocked down by Kalorn. Steps back in. Back out to center. In the midst of a change are the Penguins as it's Kalorn handing it on back. And once again, it's Matt Carl.
If you didn't know how fast Alex Kalorn is, you do now. This guy's one of the better skating big men in the National Hockey League. He can absolutely air it out.
Drouin's pass was flagged down by Hornquist. Steered on to Crosby. Sockered it back in, but the Lightning took over there.
Crosby, Malkin, Hornquist on the ice. Mike Sullivan trying to break the matchup, and he has.
TV timeout coming, getting a little extra ice time for the big guys.
Good point. Along this comes now for the punch back along by Daly, taken by Hornquist, and Malkin a shot! And that one deflected high off the glass. Popped up high. It came on along to Schuster, rammed there by Hornquist. Came back along to Palat, and then it's sent back out to center where it's Daly taking over. Hands it on back to Lovejoy. Ladled back in off the turning stick of Hornquist and then sped on back circle to circle across to Schuster. Kunoffel comes back out along with Fair and Matt Cullen for the Penguins. Nemesnikov along with Marchessault and JT Brown, who shrugged that one down, though it's played ahead and skitters back to center on the try from Cullen, who's checking his face for a stick cut. Now Coburn. Ahead now for Nemesnikov. Moving back in, Nemesnikov fed one across and well screened out with Brown. Meanwhile, it is hopped along off the stick of Cullen, flexed it on further and looked for some help, and there was none, so he went after it himself.
Yeah, that was Ian Cole that made the good defensive play there. Doc on JT Brown going hard to the net.
And it's Ian Cole who brings this ahead and shovels it carefully along to Cullen, who could not take. Under 4 minutes to go in this first period of a scoreless game number three. Coburn has this, both teams making a change. Kucherov and Kalorn and Johnson are out there for the Lightning. Stepping the way was Kessel, it's Bonino, nudging it on now to Haglund, and his shot is blocked. Another try by him, center out behind Coburn was the one who blocked the shot. Hedman out there looking to pass to him and get out of harm's way. Along now with it is Coburn. Taken away and stashed right to the front of the net, and a great save by Vasilevsky on the steal by Bonino. You're watching the NHL Stanley Cup Playoffs presented by Geico. Sticks propel pucks, but they also curve. No score.
Karrison, he's going to get it, he's going to move it to Nikita Kucherov, and then he moves himself. And you talk about giving and going, this is a perfect example. Move the puck, get to an area of the ice, and now you got an opportunity here, a little chip and chase, pull up, whatever you want to be able to attack on the offensive zone. But that all started because of a good defensive outlet by Tyler Johnson to give the defenseman a target.
Connor Sheary not on the ice with Malkin and with Russ. It's Phil Kessel taking Sheary's spot on this line. Didn't play a shift in the third period the other night. Connor Sheary.
Then ahead, tipped back off of Rust and then Filppula, but taken away by Kessel. Point a game, right on the money for him in his playoff career. This fired right back in by Dumoulin. Around it went for the jab by Garrison, the take by Strawman, and the feed for the turning Filppula. Harassing him is Kessel. Filppula around behind, tipped it on through just past Kessel, and so it could be started back up by Drouin. On across to Garrison, fed it on through, but a missed pass as it went off of Filppula and off his stick again on the clear back out.
Eddie and Doc, that was just beautiful hockey by Tack in terms of communicating and coming out of their own zone. and a great job of defending by Pittsburgh. Good hockey all around.
High skill level here. This one's thrown back down, but it won't be icing. It had to be knocked away by Vasilevsky, who has lost his goal stick.
Second time this period, Doc.
And ahead with this is Callahan. Slipped it on through in a careful block, and a penalty is coming up, and the call is a slash. Hornquist is protesting.
I think it was right at the blue line, attacking on the offensive zone. As Ryan Callahan watched the stick of Hornquist right there. Oh, that's an awful tight call there.
I don't necessarily agree
with that call, but
especially when you consider the high stick to the chops of Matt Cullen that we saw going in the last TV timeout from JT Brown. That was mild compared to that cross check to the mouth.
Power play on here in the series. 1-for-3 are the Lightning on the man advantage. This one is sent out by Bonino, and hustling back will be Hagelin, the first one there. Hagelin able to turn around behind. He's got Bonino tapping his stick on the ice. He wants it, and it's sent right back to him, and he's got it. Hagelin drifting for the pass. That does not come, but Hagelin came up with it again. More killing and splendid killing by the Penguins, but now it is Brian Boyle dropping it, and it's carried on by Hedman. Hedman able to step across the red line and drop it on back, and it's walked on by Kucherov. Now they can get it set. Hedman is at the point to give across to Boyle. The return, he had to reach and tap it on over to Drouin. A long for Johnson, but too high for him. Sent back on now for the carry back up, and it's handed back across by Fair, thrown back by Cullen, and Fair goes to the corner for it. Body position is good there. He's got it and threw one around in front that was played right back behind the net by the goaltender Vasilevsky. No shots on this uneventful power play for the Lightning so far.
Great pressure in the Penguin zone by Ben Lovejoy, and Ian Cole recognize an opportunity at a pressure point to put that pressure in and then get some help from Fair and clear it down all the way.
Frustration on the Tampa bench, a lot of door slamming.
Along it comes to Callahan. Callahan pulls and led one that's off the Penguin stick and back out again, and the Penguins make another change. So it is Garrison. Cole will work in back with Lovejoy. It's Cullen up front with Fair. Walked ahead by Palat. Palat dropped it along, intercepted by Cullen, taken by Palat. Both players went down. Cullen prevailed and dropped it back down the ice.
Got to get that puck in deeper. If you're going to turn it over, you'd rather turn it over another 50 feet in to the offensive zone. It's been easy for the Penguins. They've had good sticks, good position, and relatively easy clears.
Cupping pass, Kunitz steps by with it, penalty time is up, Daly fires it to the corner, Crosby with it, backhanded one that ricocheted back to Garrison, hunted down and shouldered there by Hornquist. 8 seconds left in the period. Crosby filtered it on through, it's sent back over to Kunitz, rifled one that's grabbed and held by Vasilevsky.
Outstanding penalty kill by the Pittsburgh Penguins. There's Ben Lovejoy. And then now all of a sudden, now you'll have pressure. Watch the pressure that happens from the Penguins. The good stick, there's the pressure point. There goes Lovejoy, there goes Cole. Good support, and now Eric Fair is able to get the puck and move it out of the zone. That is textbook by the Pittsburgh Penguins.
2 seconds left to go in this period. What will Crosby try to do here?
Looks like he's gonna try to get it back to Kessel too, but there might be time for him to try to chip it ahead and get a shot. We could go either way with his hand turned over. Looks like he's going to try to get it to Kessel.
Kicked around in front. Oh, and a stop by Vasilevsky. And that's it for the period. Wow. It was Daly at the side of the net that came up with that bouncing
pass. Yeah, defenseman just kind of up on the line there looking for an opportunity maybe to rebound. And watch the left part of your screen. The faceoff. Boyle wins it and wins it right to Trevor Daly. A missed assignment there for the Tampa Bay Lightning. And remember that stop from Andre Vasilevsky.
Liam McHugh, Mike Milbury, Keith Jones coming up on the Lexus Intermission Report. The Lightning's aggressive approach and the Penguins weather the storm. Only one penalty, that to Hornquist for slashing. 12 shots to the Lightning, 10 shots to the Penguins. No score. You're watching the Stanley Cup Playoffs presented by GEICO. No change in the scoreboard since 8 o'clock. It is nothing. Here's today's player's profile with insights from SAP. No dent made in these numbers, but they're pretty impressive. In the last 10 playoff years, players averaging 1-plus point playoff game / points per playoff game. Sidney Crosby at 115, Evgeny Malkin at 106, Ryan Getzlaf at 105, Phil Kessel and Mike Camilleri with ones. Malkin watching from the bench. It will be Hornquist and Crosby, and Kunitz out for the start. Against Okes, Brian Boyle, sure enough. Back down this goes and can be taken by Strowman. Shoved off by Kunitz. Reaching, Hornquist got it to Kunitz. Kunitz sped it along, off of Crosby and then right to the front where it had to be flexed away by Vasilevskiy and taken on by Boyle. Handed on to Paquette for Boyle but canceled out effectively by Dumoulin. Now Paquette around behind, tried to throw one in front, it ricocheted off the netminder. Matt Murray, and then this one is sent up out of play. And play halted here with Progressive Insurance taking you inside the glass with Pierre.
Thanks a lot, Doc. The third line for the Pittsburgh Penguins, they got it going on tonight. The speed of Kessel and Hagelin, very apparent. And the playmaking of Nick Bonino. There you see Bonino putting it on a tee for Hagelin. How about Hagelin returning the favor to Kessel? They're all over it. Great aggressive play on the boards. Strong. This is shorthanded with Bonino and with Hagelin. And they created all kinds of confusion for the Tampa Bay Lightning. And after that sequence, a ton of door slamming on the Tampa bench. So that third line for Pittsburgh's got it going on here tonight, Eddie and Doc.
Marchessault with that one. A turnaround shot by Nemestikov and nearly a follow through there as gliding by was Brown. Onto the back, another shot. That blocked away by Kunockel and must be retrieved out at center. Touch back to Schuster and sent right back in where Murray stops and looks. The handoff is to Lovejoy. Back up, it is rescued by Fair. Wants to play a second time and eventually through persistence alone got it back to center where it's Schuster able to see one tap back in. That reach was from Marchessault. Up with this one is Daly. Played back off of Carl. Flexed back in again on the backhand of Kunoffel. And then left by Schuster, but he recovered in time. JT Brown ahead. Hands it on to Carl. Slugged back by Letang. And eventually regathered by Bonino.
Missed opportunity there, Carl, to get that puck in deep because JT Brown was off to the races. They're looking for an opportunity to get in on the forecheck.
This one popped in the air, came back to Killorn, and then is played back out by Kucherov, though knocked off his stick from behind by Bonino. Right back in is Carl, shoved off by Kessel. Puck up the board, pinching along was Dumoulin. There to get it, Hagelin, and his shot had to be turned aside and up into the mesh off Vasilevskiy.
Well, after winning the Kentucky Derby, Nyquist faces the next challenge as he races for the middle jewel of the Triple Crown this Saturday. The Preakness Stakes coverage begins Friday, though, at 3 Eastern on NBCSN and continues race day this Saturday at 5 on NBC. And Nyquist drew the number 3 post position. And big news for Saturday, Doc and Pierre, is that there might be a little weather in Baltimore at Pimlico Racecourse, so something to keep an eye on.
How about the two-legged Nyquist leading the World Hockey Championships in scoring? He's got 7 goals for Sweden. We'll play against Canada in the quarterfinal.
Is there pari-mutuel on the World Championships?
Yes, Doctor.
I see. Okay. Here is Sheary, and there is Malkin, and then back to Lovejoy, and that one tipped wide by Russ.
Good effort there from Sheary to get on the forecheck, and then the good support from Malkin. So strength and numbers for the Penguins on the forecheck.
Malkin trying to dig it out there. Fed back by Rust, tapped across to Lovejoy, nearly handcuffed him, but he recovered well. Coburn feeds it across, Coppola got it onto Palat, back for Coppola, but blocked wide by the defensive-minded Hornquist.
One too many passes again for the Tampa Bay Lightning.
The turn by Stroman, the backhander, and that one went off the skate and hopped to the corner. Daly advances it on, Hornquist ahead, tried to play it on through, and no luck in trying to reach Crosby other than an offside.
Well, quick transition, and Ben Lovejoy is going to step up here and try to take out the Tampa Bay Lightning. It ends up being Braden Coburn who steps in. Now, all of a sudden, it turns into a quick 2-on-1. Palat's got it, and he tries to throw it back. But how about the effort from Patrick Hornquist? We talk about Alex Killorn back in the first period. Here, Hornquist comes all the way back. But again, If you're Andre Palat, how often in a game do you get the puck on your stick with nobody between you and the goaltender from about 15 feet out? It doesn't happen very often. Missed opportunity there.
Forced along by Hornquist. This one slides back down and becomes an icing.
Now, Doc and Eddie, we talked about a Boyle versus Crosby. It doesn't go away. Last change definitely benefiting Tampa, and this is what John Cooper was talking about when I interviewed with him. It doesn't always work, but it's working now, and I think it's becoming a source of frustration for Crosby and Kunitz in particular.
Offensive zone faceoff for Brian Boyle. Does not prevail on this one. It's nuts behind past Cole to Kunitz and swung on now to Hornquist. Picks up Crosby, sent it to him, he knocked it down and plays on. Back for Hornquist, and a great answer there by Vasilevsky with the left pass. Now it is Crosby again, feeding it on back. Schultz with it there. His shot deflected off of Vasilevsky and wide. Then Kunitz, then Schultz. Another shot deflected around in front. Battle score by Crosby. Backhand attempt, ricocheted off Vasilevsky. Squid wide, Hornquist took it. Backhanded it against the back of the cage.
No stick again for Vasilevsky.
He has a defender stick and is holding it now. Schultz on a cross, tapped away by Strowman. Trying to get in and being restrained. Oh, it's a penalty coming up against the Lightning. This one is speared wide. Now they touch. I thought initially the penalty was coming up to the Penguins, but it will be on Tampa Bay. And so it will be a power play to the Penguins for the first time tonight.
Best shift for that line with Kunitz and Crosby. Crosby started by batting the puck out of the air on a potential two-on-one, and then they just went on the attack. See the stick down? That was Callahan's stick that Vasilevsky let go, but the penalty already took place up high. Ryan Callahan, who had given his stick to Vasilevsky.
And Ryan Callahan without the stick in his hand. Not sure if he grabbed the stick of Chris Kunitz or not, but it's going to end up being a holding call. So after a tremendous shift that Pierre talked about by the Crosby unit, the Penguins get an opportunity with a man advantage.
1-for-6 on the power play in the series are the Penguins. Garrison in back with Coburn. Filppula up front with Killorn on the penalty kill. Sheary able to get it across. Spun right back to him by Haglin. Given on across to Daly by Schultz. Schultz there, gives it back over. Sheary, a shot, save, and it's sent away by Garrison. Kept alive by Schultz. On a cross again to Sheary. Got it on back again for Nick Bonino. Then along for Sheary off the boards. Haglin takes it. Angles it on for Daly. Let's go Bolts is the chant. Taken by Daly, given back to Schultz. Another shot. Blocked away to the glass by Vasilevsky. And this one hopped up out of play.
Eddie, in series adjustments by Pittsburgh, they always run their power play off the half boards. Look where they're coming now, to the middle part of the ice, trying to get away from those pressure points. Look where Schultz is, time and space. He can get the puck to the net. In game number two, Christopher Letang, who's on the ice now, had 7 shots on goal for Mike Sullivan. That is a very wise in-series adjustment by Pittsburgh. Don't keep the puck on the half boards. Get it up high in the middle of the ice.
And you got to change sides. When you're facing a team that's going to pressure, you got to get them moving from one side of the ice to the other in a matter of a short period of time. They're not going to be able to cover the whole sheet of ice.
Sent along by Malkin. Settled down by Kessel. Must be played at center by Letang, and he plays it all the way back for Murray.
Good stick by Boyle there to force that turnover.
So now Letang brings it ahead. 3/4 of a minute to go on this power play. It's handed over to Kessel. The number one guy is out right now. Taken along by Crosby. Gotten to Malkin and a shot. It ricocheted off the glass. Came on further for Letang. Popped one along. It's flexed across by Crosby. Could not be cleared along by Boyle. Kessel able to roll it behind. Crosby took it there. Handed it on to Malkin again. Half-boards plays it on back, and it's Letang. Got it across. Kessel a drive. Save made Vasilevsky. Rebound, another save. Malkin a shot, and that one blocked down. And can be carried back up in a 3-on-1. Walk back on by Palat. Palat is there. Tried to pass. A sprawling play. Letang bounced out in front. Filppula a shot. Save. Rebound. Palat couldn't get it loose. It's tucked in by Letang into his goaltender, Murray. from the goal crease, and it's still a scoreless game. Wow.
Well, you're exactly right, Doc. Chris Letang keeps this puck from rolling up and over the backside of Matt Murray. The puck will work itself to the front, and watch this. Pallad is there, and it goes up and over, and there's Chris Letang preventing that puck from heading into the back of the net.
Speaking of preventing, watch the guys in blue. Victor Hedman in the lane, Andre Pallad in the lane. Letang wants to tee it up. He defers to Kessel. Kessel, not known for having a great one-timer, gets it on goal. Eventually, it leads to the potential three-on-one. And Eddie, Letang made another good play during that sequence, breaking up the two-on-one and forcing Pallad outside.
This one is tucked on ahead for the carry by Kunockel. Kunockel walking it back right toward the net, is walled off enough, forced around behind enough by Strowman that the play breaks down, and now the rugby scrum begins. Fed across, and Paquette can lug it on. Lovejoy meets up with him, and the two go after it. Back in deep, now it's Daly. Fans wanted a penalty there, thinking that Daly had interfered. Off the shelf it goes, taking it as Daly, and holding, and firing one along that eventually squips to center. Carl had trouble with Fair being in his way, so the two will go to the corner to play that one. Fair able to fall down with the puck underneath. Came free to Kucherov. Kucherov still without a point in this series. The puck bounced along to Hagelin. Penguins in the midst of a change. It's Letang moving in, firing, and a save made by Vasilevsky. 13:02 to go, second period here in Tampa, Florida, and it is still scoreless. 18 minutes, it's been 17-7 in shots on goal by the Penguins. Goaltenders have been flawless. To the back it comes, Dumoulin, a shot, and that one kicked across, is sent on ahead, and here comes Killorn with some speed, but he cannot work his way through, and the play goes offside.
Now to talk about the matchup situation, Boyle versus Crosby. Boyle at 6'7", Crosby at 5'11". Couple face-off wins for Boyle, and then it's hard on him. Stick and pin him to the boards. Don't give him any free ice. Make him feel pain. Make him skate through your stick. Make him skate through your body. Try to wear him out. Deny him access to the puck. Ryan Boyle has played 9 shifts out of 11 against Sidney Crosby.
Jammed around behind and up the boards, tipped on now, and moving back up is Johnson. Passed just away from Killorn, rifled back along by Letang, who is shaking his hand, being swatted there. It is Kucherov, slipping one in front. Jostled was Letang. Puck popped up now to Bonino, and trickled on back. Spike by Garrison, taken by Kucherov, then Killorn, but then Dumoulin. Dumoulin banks one along. It is ladled back in by Kessel and taken there by Kunitz. Kunitz dropped it back in a drive by Letang. His stick is broken. Meanwhile, it is Kessel. Kessel trying to pull free. Dropped it on along, and it's Crosby losing and Boyle taking. Let it back across for Paquette. Paquette rolled it back in and went in after it. Ford stood around behind Boyle with it there. Tried to bank one in front. It went off Murray and is feathered back to center. Sent on by Hedman, given across now to Paquette. Rolled it back around, hoping for Boyle. Boyle jostled there by Cole. Squibbed on now for a play to be made by Callahan, but right on him was Cole. Lob back out again by Schultz, and this one flops back for the play by Coburn. A 9-year Philadelphia Flyer played it right back ahead for Paquette to gain the zone. And it's thrown right in front and guided away by Murray from the stick of Callahan. Another shot, and that one knuckleballed wide. Played on further and can be dragged back ahead by Malkin. Flipped back off of Hagelin, and along to play it is Hedman. Hedman guided it on, Pallad took it there. Canceled out enough by Rust that the Penguins can get back offensively, but then it's given up and lobbed back in again by Coburn. 9 minutes elapsed time, second period, no score in this game. Shots are 19-16 in favor of the Penguins. Trying to start something up again for the Penguins with that drop back in was Daly. Rolled along, though, by Strawman, the opposite number six, jammed in some traffic as falling was Kunitz, and this one caroms on back, and again it's Lovejoy. Strawman takes over there. Gave it on to Pallad. does a skyhook pass, hoping for Boyle. The bouncer is flagged down by Daly, sent right back, and Hornquist drubbed it back in so that his team can make a change, just like the Lightning are in the midst of doing.
Sidney Crosby not happy with Patrick Hornquist after he dumped the puck in there. He wanted the puck as he was coming through the middle of the ice, and I could even hear him yelling from ice level.
Boyle, a shot off the pipe! A turnover by the Penguins. Here's Callahan, and he fired it wide. Boyle playing some catch there with Garrison. It's thrown back to Letang, and then turned over again for a shot that went wide. Lightning warming to the task here. Knife back up the boards, but waiting for it, Schuster. That one ricocheted back down the ice. Will it be an icing? Racing back is Garrison, and it is.
Well, a little bit of a surge here by the Tampa Bay Lightning. The opportunity for Brian Boyle. Goes short side, low blocker, and beats Matt Murray, but off the post. Nice play there from Ryan Callahan. Two good shifts back to back for that Boyle Paquette Callahan line.
Nemesnikov to take this draw with Cullen. Cullen very experienced and having a very good average on defensive zone faceoffs, where most guys don't even hit 50%. Off this tie-up, it is poked along by Schultz, thrown back off by Letang. Bouncer kept alive momentarily by Marchessault, but then sent back out. Coburn tied up there by Kunoffel. Bear tried to work it further. The bouncer is sent back in, but very quickly they tried to reach Bear with a pass. Did not work. Nemesnikov able to scurry ahead with it now. Denied initially by Cole. Peels off. Hands one across. J.T. Brown. Dropped it back along, but has lifted quickly back out again. And a good job done by Hagelin. Meanwhile, this is sent across to Hedman. Protection slides one ahead that goes back down. Will it be an icing? No. It's brushed along by Letang. Reaching in, though, is J.T. Brown. Back across it comes, and it's Kessel there. Handing it on back for Cole. Product for the University of Notre Dame with a long toss ahead that went off of Hagelin and back down. And another change in lines for the Penguins. Not being answered right now by Tampa Bay. This one is swatted away from Nemesnikov. Shoveled back across, and on with it now is Kunitz. Kunitz fed one on. Malkin guided it across. Backhander is sealed up off the stick of Crosby by Vasilevsky. No score. Second period. You're watching the NHL Stanley Cup playoffs presented by Geico.
Crosby, you've broken here a couple times in the second. Is that a big focus for you in terms of bench management?
Well, you know, we're just going to play hockey. Our guys can play against anybody. Sid doesn't mind playing against, top checking players. He does it all year long. We'll do our best to get the matches we're looking for, but we're just trying to play.
Coach, what was the key to handling the pressure early on in this game? Because they were on you pretty hard.
Yeah, we knew they were going to come hard. We just wanted to try to keep it simple. If we had plays tape to tape, try to make them. If not, there's nothing wrong with a space play. Forcing their defenseman a turn and getting foot races.
Thanks a lot, Mike.
Okay, thanks, Pierre.
A space play. What is that?
That's a new way to say dump it in and go get it.
Okay. Cutting right through it there. This is Cole, and his stick fails him, and he's got to get back and defend.
He's got Hornquist's stick, and he is right-handed, Hornquist.
Paquette with one that's blocked by that stick.
Cole is left-handed.
Guided back up, Hornquist without a stick, goes sliding in and sockers it back out.
Excellent effort there from Hornquist.
Laid off by Hedman, wanted to take his own pass, nubbed it back in, Crosby there, able to outreach and play it along to Schultz. Reinforcements arrive, it's Malkin, flipping it ahead into the glove of Crosby, who's able to shuffle it on back and hand to Kessel. Back to Crosby, fed one that had to be guided away by Vasilevsky. Played back along by Boyle, careening heavily into the boards, shaken up a bit. Coming along and staying in the play is Kessel. Thought Phil was coming to the bench for a moment. Right back with it now comes Boyle, taken right away by Bonino and put on the stick of Kessel. Open alley up the wing. Save made by Vasilevsky.
Well, not a good change by the Tampa Bay Lightning. You have players here, and then here comes Phil Kessel. Looks like he shot out of a cannon through the middle of the ice. Look how far Vasilevsky comes out here, right on top of the blue paint, and relatively easy save where Kessel puts it right into the midsection.
And then the great effort Doc was alluding to, soccer style by Patrick Hornquist. What was amazing about that save, you got to think film study went into that. Phil Kessel spot coming down that wing, long side. Look where Vasilevsky moves. He moves from his left to his right to shut down the far side.
Here's Cullen, and the redirection was right on goal from Kunackel, and again, another important save by Vasilevsky. Lovejoy turned it along. Daly able to backhand it further. Palat dropped it back in. Knifed away, but rolling off of that was Drouin, but taken away by Lovejoy and started out to Kunackel and dropped back in.
Tampa's had any pressure or sustained offense. A lot of it has come from the back end, their defensemen being involved in the offense. The Penguins have done a really good job of not allowing them to get involved like it.
This is brought in by Crosby, and a backhander is saved by Vasilevsky. Rebound Hornquist, turned it back into Garrison, and then it's dug out and played along by Kunitz. Crosby flipped one onto the back, Dumoulin. Helder Skelder right now. Kunitz's shot, canceled right out, and a wonderful save made by Vasilevsky. And icing is called.
Assist to Mike Sullivan. He talked about not worrying about the matchup. He quick changes because he knows Boyle's not coming on. So he throws Crosby out there when they get puck possession, and they throw pucks into an area. And Eddie, we're talking about Phil Kessel. There's a feed from Bonino. Watch how he comes down the wing. You know that's a spot. And then Vasilevsky, just as he's going to tee it up, he moves to his right, knowing Kessel likes to go long side. He guessed it. He guessed right.
If you go to school now, if you're Phil Kessel, you get that same look. All of a sudden, you just pull it in and shoot back to that same side. There was a wide open net on the glove side.
Dumoulin's shot was blocked. Dumoulin got in the way, but it is flicked on back, and Letang will go to get it. 6.5 to go. Second period, game three, no score. Guided across now to Rust, but he couldn't handle the pass cleanly. It's floated back on. Letang booted it back right near him. It's taken by Malkin. Fed toward the slot. The bouncer carefully blocked by Letang onto Rust. And Rust, a backhander that is flexed away to the glass by Vasilevsky. Again, it is played along by Sheary. Goes after it and has it. Sheary back to pass in front that's shoveled on back to Letang. Drive! And that one blocked. Another try by Malkin and a save Vasilevsky. Another try and it popped up to the glass. All Penguins right now. Along to get it is Malkin, but there is Garrison. Malkin trying to pull it free. Reaching in is Schuster. Still they continue to work it along. Just by inches at a time. Malkin, but then back through Schuster. Shoveled it along further. Sheary is there, but then Garrison.
Heck of a shift for that line with Russ, Malkin, and Sheary. Sheary started the whole sequence with a good play offensively.
More attack. Malkin got it on to Dumoulin. Knifed away from him. Settled down by Letang. Tries to keep it alive and did. It's Hagelin, side of the net. Given on a cross now. And waiting and handing it on back. It came to Dumoulin. Then across to Letang again. Dumoulin once more. The big defenseman dropped it onto the turning stick of Kessel. Phil Kessel just waiting to the outside.
Got some tired players on the ice for the Lightning right now.
Hagelin back over to Kessel yet again. Dropped it back on for the turning Dumoulin. Dumoulin drifted it around behind Bonino, up with it there. Bonino protects and hands it back for Letang, then back again to Bonino. Around behind it's Kessel. Dropped it onto Bonino. Over for Hagelin off his glove. Swept back down the ice. It'll go for an icing. They won't be able to substitute, but at least they can coast around and get a little oxygen.
Got to be a timeout coming here for the Tampa Bay Lightning. This would be the third fresh line against the unit that is out there for the Tampa Bay Lightning. But the effort from Connor Sheary really started this whole sequence for that line with Evgeny Malkin and Brian Rust. Couple of great saves by Vasilevsky. And it's been all Penguins here in the second period.
Hampton just called a timeout, and wisely so. Their guys were sucking dirty pond water. They were out of gas.
To change the nature of liquids, this timeout is presented by Gatorade Frost. Play cool under pressure. Second period chances 12-3 in favor of the Penguins. The total in the game 17-6.
See, Eddie, after this timeout, with Kunitz, Crosby, and Hornquist, you might want to think about Malkin with Crosby and what they've been able to do, especially at the tail end of the second period in game number two. Phil Kessel trying to overcome that big hit, I think, from Brian Boyle earlier in the game.
And you got another TV timeout here coming shortly, and it's the opportunity to get your big guys out there, get them an extra shift here or there when you know the timeouts are coming. But look, the way the game goes, sometimes you don't get them 3-4 minutes post a TV timeout opportunity.
Great.
But right now, all Penguins.
Off the faceoff, reaching into Schuster. It came on back. It's Letang walking it on. Met there by Drouin. Tried to jam it in front. Still has it. As Crosby gives to him. Crosby turned into some traffic. Rolled it along, hoping for Hornquist, who's banged off by Garrison. Rolling off that, he's right back to duel again. And this one curled along for Drouin. And Drouin is able to hoist it back out. This one will squib back down, but there'll be no icing on this play. Killorn able to waltz back in there with Daly. Poked back up the boards, waiting for it is Hedman. Victor Hedman holding, able to step by Hornquist. Threw one in front that's held by Matt Murray. 4 minutes, 5 seconds to go in the second period. A disagreement, but that's about the only thing. Certainly no scoring, a minor penalty apiece.
Almost an instant classic right now. Playoff hockey, Garrison and Hornquist, Exhibit A. Clean, hard, and to the point. That's exactly how you want to defend, especially after that long sequence by the Pittsburgh Penguins. Job well done by Jason Garrison.
And all of this tightness and individual ability back in one's own end only draws more attention to the work being done by the two goaltenders in this game and in this series.
Vasilevskiy has been outstanding.
89 out of 93 saves versus shots on goal.
It could easily be 3-0 right now in favor of the Penguins. I mean, the quality of chances that they've had. I know Boyle hit the post a little bit earlier in the period, but the Penguins have really had a lot of traction here in the second.
Fair rifled it to the corner, hoping for a bounce, and he got it. Kunakula shot, and a bad answer there came from Vasilevskiy. Turned rack in deep again. Once again, recoiling are the Lightning defensively in their own end. Help came from Carl. Working in is Cullen. Got it on to Kessel. Kessel got it to the back. Dumoulin a shot, and that one had to be stopped, as causing trouble in front was Kunakula. Long toss ahead. Skip back down. Back to get this now as J.T. Brown locked up there by Lovejoy. Meanwhile, it can be played on further, and starting back up with it, Bonino. Nick Bonino's pass a little bit too far, and so it's Coburn sending it along, but Haglund keeping it there, and that shot directed wide by Kessel. Can be played further by the Lightning and advanced back out, but checked away by Haglund. Then turned right back into the path of Russ, starts back in with Bonino. Bonino holding, got it over to Haglund, and a save and a cover by Vasilevskiy. F1 is on NBCSN. We head to the French Riviera for one of the crown jewels of motor racing, the Monaco Grand Prix. That's Sunday, May 29th on NBC. Life at the speed of F1. There was a goaltender on this night in 1971, just out of college, named Ken Dryden, who won the Conn Smythe on the night his team won in Chicago the seventh game of the Stanley Cup Final. He was 23 years old. These two goaltenders that we're seeing in this series are 21. Here's Sheary with a shot, and that one came on around now to be played back further by Killorn.
Vasilevskiy there was thinking about heading that shot.
Did, didn't it? Lovejoy with a shot that's more conventionally held. And play stop.
That was not an easy save. That puck looked like it took off the stick of Ben Lovejoy. Might have even hit the ice there. It took a quick little skip. Another good save off the point shot. Right off the face off the shot from Connor Sheary, and probably needs to grow another couple of inches anyways.
Don't say that. Shooters around the league will get disappointed if he grows.
Still a young man. He probably still is growing a little bit.
Just
played outstanding.
One to the back, taken on by Daly.
Crosby and Malkin out there together.
Daly backhanded one that's shut off by Vasilevskiy. Why not?
Eddie and Doc are talking about the greatness of Andre Vasilevsky, 19th overall in the 2012 draft. He's been everything Steve Yzerman and the Tampa Bay Lightning would want in this playoff series. High range, slappers from Letang, in tight chances from guys like Crosby. How about Kessel come down the wing, baits him. And how about this one, through a maze of players. Unbelievable performance by Andre Vasilevsky.
Here's Malkin pulling free. Bennett onto the back and a shot. Knocked down in front. Scramble for it there and it's sent wide. Brian Boyle doing a number there at the front of the net on Crosby. Meanwhile, it's Malkin handing to Crosby. Then onto the back. It's Ian Cole. Handed it on to Malkin once again. Malkin trying to pull away from Braden Coburn. Watched very tightly by him.
Good stick there defensively.
Schultz. But the opposite way, Paquette there, and then Hedman. And it flew on back, and Schultz had it go off his glove, moving on across, just away from Callahan. Banked it ahead, Crosby shoveled it on back, and it's Cole in the last minute and 35 of this second period, and it's handed back across blindly. It's Killorn able to take it, skids down, backhands one in front, scramble for it there, big pile up, and the puck's underneath, and play is stopped.
Just a subtle little miscommunication with Ian Cole and Justin Schultz leads to that mayhem around Matt Murray. This should have been a routine play for the Penguins defenders, but look at Cole and look where Schultz was going. Schultz was going the opposite way. Killorn jumps on it, live legs off the bench, throws it out front. Callahan whacking away at it. And Ian Cole, I think, does a good job making sure he doesn't smother that with his hand in the crease, Eddie.
Yeah, bad break there for the Tampa Bay Lightning. Alex Killorn just loses an edge there, and he has one play to just try to get it to the front of the net. I think Ian Cole was anticipating Justin Schultz to cut in behind him and do a little bit of a D-to-D to reverse, defense to reverse to exit the zone. And next thing you know, Tampa had something going with fresh legs.
One on back, couldn't pull the trigger, could Kucherov, and his stick failed him, so he's gotten another one from the bench. Meanwhile, stick whacked of Bear went out of his hands. This one slipped on back, and it's Dumoulin to retrieve, put it into the breadbasket of Cullen, and then ahead now to Bear, wanting to play on through. It is Kunackle trying to jam it free. Tipped on back now to Cullen, defended by the reach of Dumoulin, carried ahead but offside by Johnson.
Talked a lot about the offense of the Penguins. How about the defense here of Chris Letang? Recognizing after the faceoff is that this is his man, so no hesitation at all. Perfectly done. Stick on stick. Prevents Kucherov. Actually breaks the stick, as you mentioned, Doc. And the Penguins are able to exit the zone. So not only the offensive part of the game for Chris Letang, but recognizing who's his man. And that's that anticipation off the faceoff.
Coburn back in. Lovejoy stymied in the corner. Up to the boards, though, and Kessel plays it across, and it's Daly. Fanned on it, and it's played back in on a delayed offside. The Penguins curl out and back in on the forecheck. Everything's fine. It's Hedman there playing it on. Swung back in by Palat, stopped by Murray. Half a minute to go in the period. Bouncer ahead, couldn't be cleared by Kessel, thrown to the corner by Hedman, and after this one is Daly. Led back across, Filppula knocked it down, carried back in by Drouin. Drouin slams on the brakes, looks for help, but it wound up going off Kessel. Can Kessel outrage Hedman? Kessel is able to bring it back in, and he shot one save. Rebound, score! Carl Hagelin picked up the rebound, and it is 1-0 Penguins.
Well, we talked about this back in the first period. Jonathan Drouin has a chance to get the puck to the net, but he pulls up, and next thing you know, the defense of the Penguins, the turnover, and Phil Kessel, as you mentioned, Doc, off to the races. The great speed from Kessel, second chance opportunity, and Carl Hagelin's right in the blue paint.
Look where Kessel shoots the puck. He shoots the puck for a rebound. He knows Hagelin's coming. He can see him to his left, see him take a quick look. Big rebound going far side. Brilliant play by Kessel. He's not shooting a score there, he's shooting a score there.
And how about Hagelin getting inside on Braden Coburn as they go hard to the net? Playing inside the dots, and that is a huge goal for a team. that outplayed the Tampa Bay Lightning for the majority of the second period. They only lead 1-0, and Tampa's probably lucky that this period is over and probably thankful that they're only down by one. But what a play by Hagelin to get inside off the play from Phil Kessel.
Liam McHugh, Mike Milbury, Keith Jones coming up on the Discover Card Intermission Report. The Pens surge in the second in part two of our Discover Day with the Cup. Hansen, Carl Hagelin, Trevor Daly. Two of them are Penguins, one a Predator. Carl Hagelin has a goal tonight at 19:50 of the second period. The GM of the Year finalists were announced today. Brian McClellan, Washington, Jim Nill, Dallas, and that man, Jim Rutherford of the Penguins.
Yeah, the voting up to and including the second round of the playoffs. Congratulations to the finalist and honorable mention in my books to Doug's, St. Louis Blues general manager Doug Armstrong and San Jose Sharks GM Dougie Wilson.
I was going to say, how about Dale Cowan? No longer the GM.
We begin the third back in the Tampa Bay defensive end. Kicked along now for Pocket. Wants to get it the other way. Was hit hard by Kunitz, but got it out. It's flipped back in again, and Crosby the first one there. Closed off by Garrison, tumbles down, and swept it one-handedly, but to Paquette.
I think some line adjustments coming up here for John Cooper and the Tampa Bay Lightning try to shake his team up after getting outshot and outplayed badly in the second period.
Handed to the front, Lovejoy with the long pass. Hagelin flags it there and drops it back in. In game two, when the Penguins seemed to be lacking energy after they were scored upon twice after having a two-goal lead, it seemed that the line changes was what got them energy again. Here is Kessel bringing this one on. Putting on the brakes, defended well by Johnson. It's handed on and given to Johnson. And then that pass, unable to take it, was Letang. An opening now for Palat, rolled it across. Too far for Kucherov, who recovers. And then flip past the waving stick of Hagelin, back as far as center, and Coburn gives to Hedman, and then back to Coburn. No! Murray sets it up there for Rust. Swept it on the long, but Johnson will get to that one. Tapped it back to the point, and it's returned right near where it can be played by Palat, but handed right back off for Letang. Just shuffles one up high that's brushed along by Schuster and played further by the defense of Carl.
One of those line changes that he was talking about with Doc. That was the original triplets line out there, not having Kalorin.
Right on goal from Sheary and stopped by Vasilevsky.
Boy, Connor Sheary's really had a good bounce back game after not playing a shift in that third period. Back in game two, he's had a lot of energy.
Here's Callahan with a shot into the glove of Murray.
Well, that's more like it for the Tampa Bay Lightning. I know it's an easy save for Matt Murray from about 45 feet out. But the shift before, Andre Palat had a chance to take a shot at the net, but he just decided to try to make a pass. And I think more pucks, more people to the net anytime the lane is there.
And a risky play by Christopher Letang right there, off to the races. Goes some pretty lethal scores, and Kucherov just couldn't handle the puck. Jonathan Drouin, after that egregious turnover in the second, now on the fourth line to start the third period.
And that's that play I was talking about. That's where Palat just got to let it go. Just get the puck to net. You just got outshot 21-6 in the second period. When the lane is there, you got to take advantage of it. And the guys without the puck have to realize that the puck's going to get inside the dots and it's going to get at the net as often as you can.
Luck back ahead now by Trevor Daly. Daly moving on, and a shot had to be held off by Vasilevsky. 96 stops out of 101 shots in the series for him.
What a game for Phil Kessel. Chances galore early on. You can see the frustration. Pucks aren't getting to the back of the net. Takes a gigantic hit from Brian Boyle. Another chance coming down the wing. Watch this one. He looks over once, looks over twice, shoots for the rebound, and guess what? Carl Hagelin, yes sir, Phil, you can celebrate.
36-point in his 36th career playoff game for Phil Kessel, including 19 goals. He's been, the numbers don't lie, he's been an outstanding playoff performer. He's had a great playoff for the Pittsburgh Penguins.
Off the short glass near Crosby. Off Hornquist and then Hedman. For JT Brown, and the shot fought off and then covered by Matt Murray. Sunday, the French Open begins as world number one Serena Williams looks to defend her title on the famous clay courts of Roland Garros. French Open presented by Longines. Coverage begins next Sunday at 1 Eastern on NBC.
Well, JT Brown now on the right side with Brian Boyle and Cedric Paquette. An adventurous save there for Matt Murray as that puck came off the stick of JT Brown. The little dipping and diving.
Face-off win by the Penguins, and turning with it is Chris Letang. Then fair, and then back in. Strawman shoved off. Puck turned over, and it's fair. Fair rolled off that, got it to Dumoulin in the shot. Squibbed right around in front, settled down there by Cullen in a lot of traffic. And it's brushed right back into some traffic. Hedman there, and fair on him. Able to spear it one along, but it kicked right back again, knocked away from Kunackel. He retrieves and sweeps it around. Then it's fair again, knocked off his stick, and finally controlled by Namestnikov. Tries to turn away from the reach of Kunackel, and does. Nicely motoring right back ahead. Namestnikov flipped one off the glove of Hadland, and it's ruled a hand pass. Play is stopped. Well, what's on the card here, young man?
Well, let's take a look at the Western Conference Final coming up tomorrow in San Jose. Game 3, Blue Sharks. Coverage begins with NHL Live at 8 p.m. Eastern, 5 Pacific. And then right back here on Friday night, Game 4 between the Penguins and the Lightning. Remember, you can also watch live online at NBCSports.com Live Extra or download the app.
If by Friday night in Maryland you are holding an umbrella, does that take away a great deal from Nyquist for Saturday?
I mean, the track was a little bit, it had a little bit of moisture in the Kentucky Derby. Not enough, I think, to make a big difference in the race. But he's never been on a so-called muddy or sloppy track. So we will see, Doc. But I don't think there's any doubt he can run on any surface. But it will be challenging for sure.
Here is Killorn rolling off that. Killorn still able to play. Jammed along further for Filppula to flip back to Killorn again. Fed back to Garrison for a shot that went just wide. Hopped along now for Killorn once more. Killorn a shot, and that ricocheted off Daly. Sent back ahead, and here's Kessel. Dropping back is Killorn. Kessel holds, waits for the traffic to flow, moves back ahead, and shot one. And that went off the glove of the netminder Vasilevsky and out of play.
How about the patience there of Phil Kessel? Tremendous patience entering the offensive zone.
Confidence is a great thing if you're a goal scorer. Phil Kessel wants the puck because he's got confidence, and there's the patience that he was talking about, and he just barely misses that one. That actually went off the crossbar on further review.
And you see the reaction of Kessel after he let it go, too, just knowing that he had him beat, grazing the top of the bar, or maybe even the back bar of the net, but again, holding on to that puck, causing some separation and not letting the big slap shot go, but that quick wrister, and what a chance.
Five scoring chances for Kessel in this game tonight, and an assist. Given up, and Boyle, and another save made by Murray on the rebound that came to Brown.
Yeah, the giveaway by Justin Schultz, and then a second chance opportunity. Quick developing play, and here's that adjustment that John Cooper has made on this line, putting JT Brown out there. Here's a gift. Boyle stops it, gets it. Second chance. Not able to get elevation up and over the glove of Matt Murray.
At some point, I think Pittsburgh needs to think about going down to five defensemen here, Eddie. Schultz has labored a little bit. You saw him have the miscommunication with Ian Cole, and right there, Boyle almost took his head off earlier in the sequence, and then it almost seemed like he didn't want the puck.
And maybe you could spot him at some point here down the stretch when the fourth line of the Lightning gets out there. You're going to have to give those, you know, the so-called big five an opportunity to breathe a little bit as this game goes on.
Swatted to the corner. Kucherov in there. Dumoulin prevail. Along Letang. That one turned right back to Cullen. And then stiffly played on now for Kunockel. And Kunockel able to lob it ahead. Eric Fair goes after this one now. Took a look and banked it around behind. Hedman had a little trouble connecting. But eventually it worked out okay for Tyler Johnson. Johnson's pass ricocheted off of Fair. Carried in by Johnson. Tries to finesse by and dropped it behind. Dumoulin reversed it there. And then was run into soundly by Palat. Shaken back in by Fair. He comes to the bench for another change in lines. Nearly 5 minutes played, third period. The shots on goal are 33-21 in favor of the Penguins. They have had a very prominent shot advantage in the series. And we get a halt to play.
It was offside there. I think Alex Killorn was just in a step before that long stretch pass by Victor Hedman.
And Jacques Martin changes the defense for the Pittsburgh Penguins. We'll see what he does. But, Doc, you were just alluding to the shot differential. Part of what's gone right for Pittsburgh, the way they're breaking the puck out of their own zone. And I think Jacques and Mike Sullivan, Doc, have come up with a great plan in terms of breakouts and breaking down the aggressive forecheck attempt.
Kessel allowed this one to go around behind. Could not be taken by Bonino, but could by Hagelin. And Bonino fed one to Kessel. He scores! The Penguins have made it 2-0, and Phil Kessel has struck.
Phil Kessel makes a great play along the boards where he almost dummies the play. The puck is going to be around the boards. Watch Kessel. It's going to get shot around, and Kessel lets this puck go right there. He lets it go. And now he gets inside the dots. Bonino, Hagelin, and then the quick release of Phil Kessel. Anton Stralman has his back to Kessel. And the sharpshooter puts it in up and over the glove of Andrei Vasilevskiy.
Now that line's been cooking all game long. We showed it in the second period, but Bonino with his skate to his stick, big body play against Filppula, gets it out to Kessel, and he finishes it to really quiet this crowd in Tampa.
20th career playoff goal.
Back in it is Russ. Backhander is turned aside by the stick of Vasilevskiy. Floated on back to center, settled down by Kucherov, moves ahead, drops it on to Johnson.
Well, they're not quiet anymore, Eddie and Doc. When you need the triplets, they decide to get going. Palat touches a puck, stretch pass to Kucherov, and Tyler Johnson on a cross and drop from Kucherov to Johnson. Both Dumoulin and Letang bite on Johnson. He shows some speed and through the body of Murray, 2-1. You couldn't pick a better time if you're the Tampa Bay Lightning to make that play.
Well, Chris Letang got lost. He could not judge the speed of Tyler Johnson through the middle of the ice. And by that time, as Kucherov cut across, as Pierre mentioned, there was no chance for him to recover. We got ourselves a one-goal game again.
14 seconds between the goals by Kessel and Johnson. A shot off the post. That one came from Hornquist. Fed back out by Crosby. Picked up and started ahead by Paquette. Shoved it off the shelf. Cole goes back and nudged it on across. Sent on by Schultz. Hedman fanned on it. And here comes Crosby ahead. Hustling up on the play, Hornquist. Crosby delays to the slot. Save, Vasilevskiy. 13:52 to go, third period of play here in Tampa. It's the Penguins 2 and the Lightning 1. Sent it by Geico. Amalie Arena, Tampa, Florida. The Lightning won the first game in Pittsburgh 3-1. Penguins won the second game 3-2 in overtime. This one is a one-goal game led by the Penguins. 14 seconds after Kessel made it 2-0, Johnson made it 2-1. A backhander is kicked out. Another save is made by Vasilevskiy.
That was Kessel on the backhand.
Laid along there by Bonino. Bonino goes in and crunches a bit with Coburn. Meanwhile, this is dragged back out again and fed across by Killorn and bunted right back in by Garrison. Kessel shunted it along, taken there by Ryan Callahan. But that went off a stick and is lifted back out again by Kessel, and it will plop back down, no icing. 6 3/4 minutes gone here in the third period. Shots are 39-22. In the series, 114-63. Brought back on and rifled wide by Brown. Thrown by Hedman, and that went off of Killorn. Blocked along and carried back up by Crosby. Takes a look. He's got Letang up on the play and fires a shot that is carefully clutched to the chest of Vasilevsky.
I've seen some pretty good work by Andre Vasilevsky playing relief for Ben Bishop. There's Phil Kessel. Eddie and Doc were talking about that two backhand opportunities. That line's been phenomenal. Kessel walking out front once and twice, and Vasilevsky denies him. Maybe Phil needs to look like that all the time. Remember, Doc, when Jim Brown used to look like he was hurt and tired after being tackled? Maybe Phil looks better when he looks tired. Goes out there and plays. Maybe he's tricking the opposition.
He shook off a lot in the Dirty Dozen movie, too. Marchessault stepped by there. Chances in the game for Tampa Bay, 10. For Phil Kessel, 8. His team has 25. He has 8 of them. Offensive zone faceoff for the Penguins here. Domestnikov tried to win it. Fair prevailed, but apparently something was not right. So they will do it again. This is what these guys have done. An assist tonight for Bonino, a goal and an assist for Kessel, and the same for Hagelin. They have produced for the Penguins.
What's amazing about that is there are people in Vancouver saying that's Nick Bonino. There are people in Anaheim saying that's Carl Hagelin. And there are people in Toronto saying that's Phil Kessel. They've all been great reclamation projects here in Pittsburgh.
This is taken on by Gruen and handed across for Schuster. Worked back over to Mesnikoff moving in. Fed one across that tipped away but is read by Marchessault and played behind. Ian Cole up with it there. Banked it back out. Carl couldn't come up with it. Kunako could, but it wound up being an offside. And maybe they just don't recognize the Bonino beard. It's a good one, isn't it?
It is.
There are quite a few of those. I've only known one so far in the playoffs that's been pulled, however. It doesn't happen too often, and I can't ever recall it. Hair pulling, especially in the 70s, yes. Because there weren't helmets then, but not beards. Whatever. Crosby and neutralized to draw with Boyle. And Crosby has now won 6 out of 7 from Boyle. And that was after losing 8 of 10 in game 1 to the very same guy. It is a different night and a different place. Lovejoy moves in, hit by Boyle. Reaching in is Crosby trying to play it free. Jammed on now to Hornquist, protects and heads back to that corner. Hoping for some help, it didn't come. Thrown by Boyle, but just nicely knifed down by Hornquist and handed to Crosby, who moves in. Crosby swirling now, holds, toe dragging a shot, save, rebound, they crash the net. Hornquist couldn't block it by, and now it has started back and shaken up on the play. One of the Lightning back, it is Paquette. Meanwhile, this shot goes wide. JT Brown was denied by Dumoulin.
Boy, that last chance for Sidney Crosby, that's the third chance he's had here in the last couple of minutes, almost from the same exact area of the ice.
Strawman wiped out. Dumoulin played it around behind. Played currently up the boards, but right to Johnson. Sends it the other way. They wanted to reach Palat with a pass. Kucherov could not do that.
Good stick by Bonino defensively.
Rattled on around, shift change on. Hagelin able to filter it back, but we get a halt to play as the puck went out of play.
The Tampa Bay bench is irate at that man. Let's see what he does to Cedric Paquette. Is that a slew foot? Sure looks like it. And they were very vocal down here on the Tampa bench.
It never takes long in either venue for the fans to find a villain. It happened in game 1, it has now happened here. But it is late in game 3. The fans can be preoccupied with it, the players cannot. Lifted back in by Palat. Letang to get it there. Reversed it along and then was run into by Palat. As mentioned one time earlier, the leading hitter for Tampa Bay in this series. This one played along now to Strawman. Strawman ripped it ahead on the turning stick of Johnson, who gallops right back in with it. Played back over to Kucherov, and a shot is a save for Murray. And then he crumples down as a little extra came after he made the save.
Matt Murray looks like he's shaken up a little bit as he was moving left to right to make that save. And more times than not, when you're left-handed shot and you come across the ice like that, you're looking to move that puck back to where you come from. So Kucherov's going to be in the left part of your screen. He's going to get it moved to our right, and you try to shoot back the other way. And there you see Tyler Johnson makes contact with Matt Murray. Then you see a slash and a punch and everybody just coming in. You better be awfully careful in the stoppage of play. And we have a couple of penalties here, so they're going to even it out. But on that play by Kucherov, just wasn't able to get that puck upstairs, up and over the glove, where haven't been many blemishes on the resume of Matt Murray in this playoff, but a couple of them have been over his glove.
Matt Murray shaken up on a similar play on the final day of the regular season in Philadelphia.
Well, Doc just talked about it. Pays to have great tape off. Braden Shen going hard on Matt Murray. Boom. Virtually the same play.
Seemed more forceful that day, and he had to leave. And they had to go with Jeff Zatkoff in the first two games against the Rangers. He won one and lost one. Letang and Palat for roughing Minor. Four aside. Crosby stepped in. It's played back along. Out of all of this, it's Killorn, but then Kunitz. Crosby was breaking, hoping it would come to him. Kunitz still battling, trying to make that happen, and it becomes an offside. 10:37 to go. Third period of a 2-1 lead for the Penguins.
Well, Pierre showed us the contact back in Philadelphia, but there's Tyler Johnson going hard to the net, and yeah, you see the knee. A great look from our terrific crew here down in Tampa, and boys will come together. So a little four-on-four hockey here. The forwards have the defense, and the defense have the forwards. A lot more room to be able to make some plays and create a offensive opportunity with a lot more room.
So now it's Daly with Lovejoy and Malkin and Hagelin. Hedman and Coburn the defense. Johnson working up front with Kucherov. The forwards for both teams impressive. The defense as well are good at that. And then catching one up high was Hagelin, and a penalty is coming up against the Lightning.
Again, Coburn. Talked about the man-on-man play. Braden Coburn right there on Carl Hagelin. Four on three hockey in favor of the Penguins. The Coburn's got what, probably about 5 inches on Hagelin there, Doc? Size-wise through the middle of the ice. And remember, Daly stood behind his own net there for probably a good 10 or 12 seconds waiting for the Penguin forwards to swing back, open up a little bit of ice, and then it was the quick play, the redirect by Malkin, and then the penalty happened.
Not the conventional power play. This is a 4-on-3. Kessel out there along with Crosby, tried to win the draw, could not, and it's cleared back down.
Good face-off there by Filppula and Crosby.
Filppula and Boyle and Strawman, the iron three in front of Vasilevskiy. Brought right back ahead and settled down by Schultz. Gives back to Crosby. Crosby dropped it off. Malkin takes it there. Then Schultz, then Kessel. Kessel drifting, sprint front, and it's sent away by Crosby. Partly canceled out, taken back on by Kessel. Kessel rifled it across, held there, and set up for Schultz. And that one directed up high by Philpula. Screened out was Crosby by Boyle. Played back along by Malkin. Walked across by Schultz and given to Kessel. Kessel a shot, and that one turned aside. Kessel yet again. Worked it onto the back. Schultz with it there. Malkin settles it down. Has Crosby near the front. Malkin drifts to the outside, took a look to him, and then gave it to him. Crosby has a man in front, Kessel. It's Crosby, a shot. He scores! Crosby, and it's 3-1.
Tremendous puck movement by the Pittsburgh Penguins. They work the puck on the left side to the right side of Andrei Vasilevsky, and then all of a sudden a little interchanging going on. Now they move it onto the left side. Little pitch and catch. Malkin puts it on a tee, and Crosby just blows it over the glove of Vasilevsky.
Time, space, grip it. Two-goal lead.
But he just puts it right in the wheelhouse. But adjustments, and working the puck on one side of the ice. The reaction from Vasilevsky. But the Penguins not seeing and not getting what they want on their left side, so they move it to their right side, and the guys that you want dictating the terms on a power play, Malkin and Crosby connect, and they get their two-goal lead back with their 42nd shot of the game.
They're starting to pile up some pretty substantial shot totals. 41 in game two, 42 here in game three, and we still have 9 minutes to go.
The Whistler goal scored by number 87, Sidney Crosby.
Johnson banked it around behind. Kucherov took it there. With under 9 minutes to go, the deficit for the Lightning is 2. And that flipped out of play into the Penguins bench. You guys tell me at which can we take chances. Well, one thing we aren't going to do is take a chance now. Because we like the money, right?
Oh, yeah.
We're going to sell you something here first, and then we're going to answer the question.
Probably a little bit too early here. I think once you start getting below the five-minute mark, I think that's when you start really taking chances. Both defensemen pinching in. If you give up an odd man situation, so be it. But I think you'll see the defensemen being really aggressive. And maybe at some point here, does John Cooper, with less than four or five minutes to go, decide to pull his goaltender for the extra attacker if they are indeed still down by 2 goals.
Haglund sends this one back. Jason Garrison up with that. Spun it back to Schuster. Had a little trouble. Doubled back and counted on Garrison. Off of Marchessault. Fed back out again by Dumoulin, who has become very reliable from the start of this season to now for the Penguins defense. Garrison twisted that one behind. The shots in the series, 118-64. Tonight, 42-23. Penguins ahead in both of those departments as this is sent back out now and chipped back in by Killorn. It is Daly defensively. Locked up by Philpula, taken along and sent by Matt Cullen. Good anticipation there by Coburn, jabbed it on around, and Philpula waits. Here's Philpula wanting to step by Daly. Centered one, but it was off the frame, and lobbed back out again by Fair, and he is going after it. Is ahead of Carl. It's Fair a drive, save made there by Vasilevsky. Scooped up by Coburn, and pitched back ahead. Dumoulin will drop back to play it. 7.5 to go here in the third. Banged off of Coburn. Kept alive there by Killorn, and Killorn able to move freely with it. A cluster of players gathered near the front have peeled off. Now centering pass directed right on by Brown, and eventually stopped and thrown again, and that one wide. Around to take a whack there from Cullen was Boyle. Meanwhile, that toss knocked the stick out of the hand, or perhaps broke it for Hornquist, so he comes to the bench in the midst of all the confusing changes. Here's Boyle, a shot that steered to the glass by the reach of Cole. Fed back around, and the bouncer, it can be scooped back out. Malkin there, got away from Paquette, moves in with Kunitz, got it to him. Save made by Vasilevsky. Kunitz again, he scores!
Well, after making a tremendous save, Cedric Paquette puts this puck right on the tape of Chris Kunitz and ends up in the back of the net because he bounces it in, I believe, off of Vasilevsky. But quick strike through the middle of the ice. Strength by Malkin. There's the first save.
And then it's right there off of Vasilevsky into the back of the net by Kunitz.
And how about Matt Murray at the other end of the ice? He comes up large. There's your NBC. It Vasilevsky can't move across the crease. He's probably expecting a pass. But Matt Murray at the other end came up large with the aggressive Tampa Bay Lightning throwing pucks on Matt Murray.
So it is 4-1 with 6:48 to go in the third.
The Pittsburgh goals.
Now you readjust the time on that to now.
Yeah, now's the time. You got to start pitching in everybody. And you give up a 2-on-0, so be it. Still some time here.
Right out in front, another shot is sealed up by Vasilevsky, who has been overwhelmed back in his own end of the ice by just constant Pittsburgh attack.
Doc, you were talking about Hornquist. He blocked a shot. You heard his hand. He's gone to the Pittsburgh Penguin dressing room. So he's not here right now. See him get in the lane. Watch that puck hit him in the hand. And he's going to let that stick go because that hand hurts. He talked to Chris Stewart, the trainer, and off he goes. And that's Chris Stewart following behind, the medical trainer for the Penguins.
Thanks for the help there, Pierre. The way he dropped it, I thought maybe it had broken, even though it didn't break in half. But so we'll watch to see if he returns to the bench. Meanwhile, this is brushed back on by Lovejoy. So now the deficit is a huge one. It is 3. That one is handballed right back by Lovejoy, and pivoting with it is Coburn. Braden Coburn laid it on across. Victor Hedman brought it ahead. Shoveled it back in, and they go in after it, but it's Lovejoy there prevailing along for fair, and he directed it back down, and there's no icing. Vasilevsky flipped it along. It skipped on through, but it's played by Coburn across to Hedman. 6 minutes to go. Marchessault had trouble with the checking of Malkin. Along comes Crosby. Then Malkin again turned around, tried to play, but could not. Sent back over by Domestikov, shaken up on the play is Rust, and a penalty is coming up against the Lightning. 5:48 to go, third period. The tide has turned. 4-1 Penguins. So it is Coburn in the box. Penguins to the power play with a 3-goal bulge and 5:48 to go. Here's the penalty.
And there's a close shave from Braden Coburn to the face of Brian Rust.
It is Letang a drive and a save made by Vasilevsky.
Well, this morning for the Tampa Bay Lightning, they had a little action with Ben Bishop taking some shots. Doc and Eddie, I wonder at some point if people would start to wonder if Ben Bishop's good to go, if John Cooper maybe doesn't go back to Bishop, if he's okay.
We shall see.
And Vasilevsky's been incredible in this game, and it's probably flattering to the Tampa Bay Lightning that it's only 4-1.
Totally agree.
We need to figure out how to play that speed game again that we saw in the first period. We've seen a lot this year because last two games the Penguins have dictated the terms and outshot almost 2-1 in the last one plus games, 88-45 to this point, and the goaltender has been outstanding.
26 chances to 9 in the second and third period of this game. Settled down by Matt Murray. Schultz chased off, but not until he'd released it onto Bonino. No particular hurry for the Penguins on this advantage, which is halfway done. A single shot on goal on this power play, and the clock has bled down to the last 4:40. Hagelin there, fed one through, turned aside by Vasilevsky. Sailed back out again, and it bounced near Daly, but is taken on by Johnson. Johnson wanted to force it on further, and it bounced behind for Letang. Connects with Daly. Led back over for the carry back up by Kunitz. One of several heroes for the Penguins in this game. It's fed on now for Bonino, but that tapped right back. And another shot went wide. Schuster had a little trouble with it, and J.T. Brown did not. Cleared back down in the last 20. To a smaller minute number, we are about to go. In 13 seconds, Coburn will be out. And it will take a miracle. Those have happened. But the way the Penguins have played tonight, it is less likely than you would think. But here's Cullen shooting, and that one ricocheted back. Out of the box now is Coburn, taken on by Paquette. He floated it back in. Dumoulin took over there and dropped one back down. Kunockel chases it back, and he will arrive there to play it along now to Matt Cullen. Cullen couldn't get by Carl, swept along by Rust, and now Hedman. Under 3.5 to go. Carl threw it across. Kucherov brought it on. Nice move by Drouin, but he could not get it by the defense, and it just played back out again, and again they have to settle it down. Off of Drouin, knifed away from Namestnikov, played behind to Daly. Rattled around to Malkin, directed back on, but Rust was screened off by Drouin. Under 3 minutes to go as of now. Given on to Malkin. Malkin twisted it, Crosby a shot, and a sprawling block by Namestnikov. It is Malkin again. If they wanted to pull their goaltender, they've not been able to do it yet. We will keep an eye back that way as it's dropped back in. He is not going to come off.
He's looking at the bench too, Doc and Eddie. He's definitely looking.
Dumoulin rolled it on. Second effort by Kessel, got it ahead near Bonino, but then played back on to Filppula. Filppula just holds through traffic. Filppula sent it on across. Hedman with a shot, and that hit someone about 10 feet out in front of the net. Dumped back ahead, chasing it down as Kessel. Stepping out to play one along with Vasilevsky, and then fanning on it on the pass from Kessel is Hagelin. It's Hedman able to march it ahead. It's passed for Callahan failed, and it's just sent back in by Bonino. Comes to the bench again with 2:05 to go. Racing ahead with it now is Johnson, and Johnson moving on there and backhanded one that was shut off by Murray, and Murray just sits down on it to get the stoppage of play. It was around 9:30 this morning that Eddie Olczyk and I were sitting up in the stands and saw this. Pierre was over on the other side and very alert while doing a radio show. Well, he was one of five this morning, Pierre, but we were all watching the same thing. And that was Ben Bishop getting warmed up.
Actually looked more comfortable on the ice than he did when he was leaving the ice. He made his way into the Lightning locker room in the tunnel in behind the bench. I think the Tampa Bay Lightning have a few bigger issues than who's going to partake in goal for them in game four. They've been outplayed here the last couple of games.
To go.
Well, you can expect the goaltender to come out for the extra attacker here at some point if the Lightning can regain control. But we talked about faceoff plays, being able to set up and have set faceoff plays off of one draw, and that's exactly what happens here. Carl to Kucherov to Palat, who goes top shelf over the glove of Matt Murray.
So for Kucherov, that's his second point of the night and second point of the series. A modest breakout for him here, and with a minute 44 to go, back on the attack now come the Lightning. It's Johnson, a shot that's steered up high by Daly. The net is empty at the opposite end. The puck came out of play. The faceoff will be in the offensive zone for the Lightning.
Remember, Tampa used their timeout back in the second period for that extended shift, so not able to draw anything up. The one thing they have been able to do in this series consistently is win some faceoffs and create off of set faceoff plays, and now they got a faceoff to the left of Matt Murray.
So it's Johnson in to take it, opposite Sidney Crosby. Whacked on the bounce now to Hedman. Hedman drifts and hands it on across. Moving in, Drouin, a shot. Rebound, Palat, oh, and he couldn't get it past. Meanwhile, Kucherov tries to play it on out of a rugby scrum of five players. It bounces on, flexed by Hedman. Knocked down by a high stick and back out. And play will continue as Hedman is the guy who takes it. 1:12 to go. Net empty at the other end. Bringing it back in is Boyle. Boyle drives to the net and fed one in front that's scooped away. Sent along there by Daly. Turn to the front again and kicked aside. Hagelin able to pull it free. Nudge back across. Letang able to get there. And send it at far center. And then Fair with a shot that went wide. No icing on the play. He was across the checkered line at the time. Started back by Drouin. Long pass was shuttled down by Kunackel and sent back by Cullen and wide. Again, no icing on that play. They were safely across the red line. 38 to go and the deficit 2. Long toss by Hedman. Flagged down by Lovejoy. Played to Kunackel and he misfired on the pass that was just away from Cullen. Gliding along with it is Alex Killorn, 25 to go. Killorn brings it ahead and lobs one that is scooped up there by Murray, and he will hold an offensive zone faceoff for the Lightning with 21.8 to go.
Well, some help there from Matt Murray as Nick Bonino comes flying all the way across. Andre Palat, who scored the last goal, got an opportunity, and a left skate save and a beauty by that man right there.
As prep school coach John Gardner and his college coach Jack Parker looking at that saying, he was always that good defensively.
He looked strong on that play, didn't he? Puck sent to the back, Kucherov a shot, oh, and a sweeping move by Matt Murray and a little extra after the whistle.
For Lauren and Daly.
Talk about set faceoff plays in offensive zone situations. Kucherov playing on the right point. He's a left-hand shot. He wants it in his wheelhouse, and he just smokes that on goal with traffic trying to get to the net. Trevor Daly, I think, Eddie, does a great job making sure Killorn doesn't get there, and maybe not as eagerly as maybe he wanted to.
And Nemestrikov has a chance to get to the net there, and here you see Trevor Daly, who's had a fantastic series, got a little bit of an abrasion on the left side of his face. But Letang was able to win that battle, and Nemestikov not getting to the front of the net, allowing Matt Murray to see that last shot.
Everything's gone Pittsburgh's way here. They've earned it through hard work. The one little concern, Patrick Hornquist with that shot block, Doc and Eddie, he has not come back to the bench. And that's something significant. That could mess up some of the chemistry the Pittsburgh Penguins have had.
Killorn got 2 minutes for roughing and a 10-minute misconduct. Daly got 2 for roughing only. And Killorn has now taken the league lead in penalties. Here's a shot that directed wide. Chipped along further. Little extra shot on Cole. In the last 7 seconds, puck came across the net mouth. They set up there for Kucherov, has trouble controlling, 2 seconds and one. And the Penguins are up 2-1. The last try by Johnson hopped wide.
The final score on the Pittsburgh Penguins.
Hagelin, Kessel, Crosby, and Kunitz. Kessel with a goal and an assist. Hagelin with 1-1 as well. Palat and Johnson had the goals in a losing cause for the Tampa Bay Lightning. The final score, the Penguins 4 and the Lightning 2. Time now for the 3 stars of the game, brought to you by Chase Freedom Unlimited. Before you turn to horses, pick 3 hockey players.
Well, you got to go with Phil Kessel and Carl Hagelin playing on the same line. Kessel could easily had 3 or 4 points in this game. He was outstanding, and this game could have been over, Doc, after the second period. The Penguins had 21 shots in that second period. And Andrei Vasilevskiy, even though he gave up 4, I thought he was outstanding in this game.
Boy, he was. You boxed a trifecta of 3 very strong players in this game.
I'm in.
We'll be back to hear from Matt Murray, the goaltender for the Penguins, when our coverage of the Stanley Cup playoffs between these Penguins and these Lightning continue after these messages.